Hi everybody, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. Here's an update what's going on at Yellowstone. The live webcam and the static cam for Old Faithful still isn't working. I do have an image here from 2:30 p.m. local time of Yellowstone Lake. Yeah, that's all I can get for you. USGS is reporting 117 earthquakes within the last probably 24 hours. The most recent they're saying is a magnitude 2.5. It's actually a magnitude 3.0. It's shallow, 2.4 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured in sea level. I have four monitors. I did download the promontory, like I said I was going to do yesterday. Here on the left is Mary Lake. This is the borehole for Yellowstone Lake. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, this is a 3.0. Here we have the promontory and the western boundary. And let's go to the borehole. And we'll bring this down so you can see it. For those of you that might have larger screens or watching on your TV, maybe with your Fire Stick, whatever. Yeah, see, this is a magnitude 3.09. And there's been one, two, three, probably four earthquakes when I downloaded the data. Let's see, we'll look at that one. And that one. I'm off the line. Okay. And let's look at the seismic signature. Once again, it goes small on me. Okay. And let's go to this one. We'll check out. Yeah. Volcanic tremors and harmonic tremors. Okay. I'll just go back to that without making it large. See that? Yeah. I really wish they would give me, or give the public, I should say, access to the gas readings. They have one monitor that I know for sure is taking continuous gas readings. I don't remember where I got this image from, but it says a continuous gas monitoring station operates near Yellowstone National Park, the Norris Geyser Basin. Scientists with the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory plan to expand continuous gas monitoring as part of a new volcano and earthquake monitoring plan for the Yellowstone caldera. So they have several solar panels, and yeah, looks like they're taking wind readings and things like that. And you can see here, they have a pipe that comes up out of the ground. Actually, it looks like two, maybe. Yeah. This data is being sent to them. I don't know how often. It says continuous. Let me bring this over. Yeah, I don't know. Anything done in secret is not good. With the live gas readings, we would know how close Yellowstone is actually to an eruption. You know, we would have the hydrogen 3 and 4. We would have CO2, sulfur dioxide. All that data. They just posted this earthquake, at 2012 universal time. And they're saying it's a magnitude 1.5, but I get a 1.90. It might be a little bit larger though. 2.2 miles. And, you know, the roof of the caldera is only about 3 miles down. Look at all those earthquakes. You know, it was kind of a slap in the face to say that earthquake swarms of this magnitude happen maybe 2 to 3 times a year, which is hogwash. So far, they've had 14 earthquakes over a magnitude 2.5. The largest being a magnitude 3.7. That one was shallow too. 2.3 miles. We got two 2.7s, a 2.8, another 2.7. Maybe I'll click on them for you. Maybe I should bring it out a little bit farther. No, we'll just keep it right there. Okay. Oh, and a 2.9. Remember, they got this crack, this fault zone that runs underneath the lake, where dike intrusion is trying to come up. It's got a cap of rhyolite, which is the most explosive type of magma possible. Yeah, they have earthquake swarms, but not with a magnitude 2 or greater. No, that doesn't happen. Normally, they're around a magnitude 1, maybe a little bit bigger and smaller. This is very unusual. There was an earthquake in Chile. I posted about that, and it definitely shook up the caldera here. All right, let's go to the promontory. And I'm going to show you first on Google Earth where the promontory is at. This here is Yellowstone Lake. For those of you that might be new, this little thumb pointing out is the promontory. And that's the monitor that I'm going to show you. And then up over here is the borehole. It's a very deep well under the ground for Yellowstone Lake, borehole 208. In the area where they've been having the earthquakes, there is a bulge there where the ground's been rising. This here is Mary's Bay. Yeah, that eruption, which created this little knob here, I guess you can call it, threw out rocks miles away and created a tsunami across the lake. So I am wondering if it's got to do with the bulge or if there's a weakening of the crust there where the magma's trying to come up. This is just some of the earthquakes I posted. All right, so right down here is the magnitude 6.3 earthquake that occurred there in South America off of Chile. And let's bring this over. You can see that it really shook up the caldera. Yeah. And then this is the more recent one here. You can see we got hot gases, hot water that came up. And there's the one that they're saying is a magnitude 1.5. They haven't reported this one yet. This here is what the stream view is currently showing. I did not download Madison River area because if I get more than four different monitors, yeah, it just messes up on me and locks up and doesn't download. So up here at the Madison River area, we got a small quake that came in recently there. It would be in that location because it only shows there and on the western boundary. It doesn't really show up for Yellowstone Lake, Mary Lake, or the promontory. You can see the gaps right here. I would say that there is a bulge growing, that the lake has been tipping more and more. Let me go there. Oh, went off the line. Yeah, and then we got that one. There are actually two there. Yeah, those two are not being reported. Yeah, back to their same old, same old. Yeah, they're really messing up today. This one here, they're saying, is a magnitude 0.7. It is actually a magnitude 2.20. Don't want to freak people out, right? I'll bring it down there at the bottom. You see MD 2.20. And we'll come back up. They got another one, but it's not marked in red. 2328. They're saying that one is a magnitude 1.1. But it's actually a magnitude 1.97. More than likely, it's the fault moving. Yeah, this is either fault movement or tectonic. You know, they got that fault that comes up all the way through the Tetons there. They are saying this one here at 310 is a 2.1. Let's go to the spectrogram. But I get a magnitude 2.38. Yeah, I don't know who they got working there. Yeah, more gases coming up here. I was wanting to see what was going on when we got the uplift going on there. Yeah, hot water and gases. Got another little one there. And another little one there. Let's look at the seismic signature. I'll have to make that bigger. Yeah, I would say there's a crack opening up. All right. This here is the borehole for Yellowstone Lake. Borehole 208. Look at that. Oh, my goodness. I say, oh, my goodness, because of all the hot water and hot steam and the magma. Let's pull this over. Yeah, I thought maybe it was going to be settling down, but I don't know. It's still acting up, isn't it? Yeah. Like I said, this is when I pulled the files a little while ago. All right. See, this is volcanic tremors. Yeah. That's that one there. Okay, it's going to go small on me. Okay. And that's the 1.90. There's actually two here. Let me make that bigger. Let me close that. Make that bigger. Yeah. All right. Let's. Now that one is fault movement. And yeah. What can I say? All right. Let's make this bigger. Not good. What's going on? Yeah. Yeah, this is all fault movement. Yeah, or tectonic. Yeah. Yeah. Not good. All right. Let's go back up. Now, when the Hunga Tonga volcano erupted, it only took 1 hour once the magma started to come up for it to have its major eruption. 1 hour, that's all it took. So, yeah, I don't know what they're up to. Everything is A-okay, right? All right. Yeah, monitor's not working. What are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. I'll keep watching. And I'll keep you up to date. As always, please be prepared for a disaster. You don't know what it could be. It could be, yeah, a volcanic eruption. It could be another train derailment like they had there today or last night. They had an evacuate. Minnesota? Was that Minnesota? I don't remember. Okay. I hate that when it goes small and you guys can't see it. Yeah. Anyways, yeah. If you got any comments, please put it down below. It's the end of the month, so make sure that you are still subscribed to your favorite channels. The AI, for some reason, at the end of every month, unsubscribes people. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.